Dying to be Stuckmocky, Chapter 29. Another Stuckmocky joins the clan. "Oh, that's right. I guess I never told you, did I?" said Vira to Mirrin. "Fahyrjeon showed me a baby in its pouch." She then turned to Fahyrjeon with a confused expression, similar to Mirren's. "But she already has a baby, so why..." Mirrin interrupted. "It is best not to investigate these creatures. It can only lead to mental derangement." Wishoah chose that moment to lean forward over Mirren's head and carefully insert its finger up his nostril. Fahyrjeon barely broke eye contact with Vira as it pulled the probing finger away. "You nearly became the baby's other birth parent when you offered Vahyrjeon that piece of fruit, remember?" "Really?" exclaimed Vira with shock. "Is that all it takes?" "Obviously not, but the offering and acceptance of fruit in that situation is a binding social contract." Vira opened and closed her mouth soundlessly, trying to get her head around the concept of a baby that already existed but which still needed a second parent. She didn't notice Wishoah's finger was wandering towards her open mouth, but Fahyrjeon intercepted it as Vira clapped her hands together on the other side of the cave. Immediately all the visitors shuffled towards the tunnel mouth and began to exit one by one. The last one to crawl through reappeared a moment later with the second bucket of water Mirrin and Vira had fetched from the stream and which had been left at the other end of the entrance.
"Oh, thank you so much," said Vira, wishing she knew how to say it in Stuckmocky.
She smiled her broadest smile instead, and the Stuckmocky smiled back before disappearing into the tunnel once more. Vira carried the bucket over to the water barrel and emptied it in. As she did so, she eyed the teetering pile of fruit next to Vahyrjeon, lightly dusted with the inevitable coating of orange-brown fur.
"Vahyrjeon, do Stuckmocky eat anything besides fruit?" she asked hopefully.
"Oh yes," it replied as it stood, scooped up an armful of hay and began spreading it across half the floor of the cave. "Fruit alone wouldn't be a balanced diet." Fahyrjeon paused and looked intently into the hay at its feet. It suddenly darted a hand down and plucked out a twitching grasshopper. Before Vira could express her relief at its capture, the unlucky insect was popped into a toothy mouth and swiftly crunched into oblivion.
"Yes," said Vira after a quick swallow. "We eat a wide variety of foods, so I'm sure there will be plenty for you to enjoy if fruit isn't your favourite."
Vira hurriedly said, "Oh no, just asking. I love fruit, actually." She silently hoped Vira and Fahyrjeon would make a thorough buffet of the bedding before it was time to sleep. She helped spread the remainder of the hay, creating a large, deep mat with additional hay that Fahyrjeon was now hauling into the cave. As they worked, Vira sprinkled into the mat some dried purple flowers from a wooden bowl, and Vira breathed in the pleasant aroma the combination created. Maybe bedtime wouldn't be so bad after all. Suddenly, a straw-coloured mouse darted from the hay and streaked between Vira's feet, across the floor towards the tunnel. Vira jumped back against the cave wall in surprise and felt the phosphorescent mushrooms behind her squish under her weight.
"The lavender appears to be taking effect, Vira," said Fahyrjeon, as an alarming assortment of large and small insects made their way to the surface of Vira's future mattress.
Fahyrjeon bustled forward to dart its hand in and out of the straw, dropping some insects to the floor to be stomped on, while others were enthusiastically popped into its mouth. As far as Vira could tell, the two Stuckmocky were partial to grasshoppers and beetles, but other varieties of bug weren't on the menu. Maybe, just maybe, she could one day learn to like crunching on chitinous exoskeletons, she thought, but right now she was wishing she hadn't so recently studied insects in such detail in biology. Mirrin, meanwhile, seemed oblivious to the feeding frenzy in progress and was slumped on the floor by the water barrel, staring gloomily into the empty pail between his legs. Wishoah ambled over to him and placed something gently into the bucket, then sat down and snuggled against Mirren's legs, while draping one arm over the bucket rim and grunting gently. Wishoah's interest seemed entirely absorbed by the bucket's contents, so Vira's curiosity was aroused. She cautiously stepped forward to take a peek, hoping she wasn't going to regret it. Scamping around the bottom was the little straw-coloured mouse, chased by Wishoah's finger. The sprog kept looking up encouragingly into Mirren's unresponsive face, and eventually took hold of his hand and dragged it into the bucket to stroke the new pet. As Mirrin observed Wishoah's delight, tears started to his eyes. He looked up at Vira desperately.
"I cannot be this creature's parent. Surely I cannot. I am not Stuckmocky. It will never be allowed."
Actually, interjected Fahyrjeon, gulping down a particularly large, delicious beetle. You are Stuckmocky. Vira proposed you to the clan for rescuing it from the cage, and you were accepted during the same ceremony Vira was. Didn't I make that clear? No, you didn't, replied Mirrin and Vira together. Fahyrjeon stared at them both, seemingly a little hurt at their lack of exuberance at the welcome news. Anyway, it continued after a moment, it means there's absolutely no objection to Wishoah adopting you, which it clearly has, since it's now presented you with a gift. Tears began leaking out of Mirren's eyes and dripping unnoticed onto Wishoah's furry head. I've never seen a sprog adopt someone so readily. You must truly have a special quality about you that Wishoah craves, admitted Fahyrjeon, with just a hint of reluctance. It held out a beetle towards Mirrin, who didn't even notice, then offered it instead to Vira, who smiled weakly and shook her head. Are you sure? Asked Fahyrjeon. There's only cupcakes to eat at the weyrshofft celebration, and they can get a little monotonous.
Cupcakes! Exclaimed Vira. I thought you said we'd already had the ceremony.
The ceremony, yes, said Vira, standing up and holding out his hands to Mirrin and Vira. But we haven't celebrated yet. Come along. It grunted something to Wishoah, who picked up the mouse and held it out to Mirrin. When he didn't respond, the sprog shrugged, opened its pouch, and tucked the mouse carefully inside. As Fahyrjeon turned to leave the cave, it suddenly darted a hand down to the floor and seized a prize morsel. With a triumphant grin, it held up a large, wriggling cockroach, which it then tucked into its pouch also.
Something for later, it clarified.
As the five Stuckmocky made their way to the tunnel mouth, Vira whispered to Mirrin,
Now I'm not sure whether that mouse is your pet or a future snack.